Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 15, Example 2. In this example, we want to solve the equation 20 over a squared plus a minus 6 plus 6 over a plus 3 equals 5 over a minus 2 for a. The goal here is to get a by itself on one side and everything else on the other using inverse operations. When we do the inverse operations, we want to make sure that we do the same thing to both sides in order to keep the two sides of the equation equal to each other. In step 1, we want to simplify the equation by removing the fractions. We can do this by multiplying by the least common denominator, or LCD. It looks like we can factor our first denominator and get 20 over a plus 3 times a minus 2 plus, and we'll still have our 6 over a plus 3 equals, and the right side will still be 5 over a minus 2. The fact is our denominators are a plus 3 and a minus 2, so our least common denominator is a plus 3 times a minus 2. Let's see what it looks like when we multiply both sides by that least common denominator of a plus 3 times a minus 2. A plus 3 times a minus 2 times the 20 over a plus 3 times a minus 2 will leave us with just the 20. Plus, an a plus 3 times a minus 2 times 6 over a plus 3 gives us 6 times a minus 2. And over on the right side, the a minus 2's cancel, and we're left with 5 times a plus 3. In step 2, we want to solve the remaining equation. We can remove the parentheses by using the distributive property. So on the left side, we will get 20 plus, and 6 times a minus 2 is 6a minus 12 equals, and distributing that 5, we get 5a plus 15. Combining like terms, we get 8 plus 6a on the left side equals 5a plus 15 on the right side. Next, we want to get all the a terms on one side. The inverse of plus 5a is to subtract 5a, so we'll end up with 8 plus 6a minus 5a equals 5a plus 15 minus 5a. On the left side, that gives us a plus 8 equals, and the 5a's cancel on the right side, and we're left with 15. It looks like we have the constant term of 8 to move. The inverse of plus 8 is to subtract 8 from both sides. So we'll get a plus 8 minus 8 equals 15 minus 8. On the left side, the 8's cancel, and we have a equals, and on the right side, 15 minus 8 will give us 7. In step 3, we want to check for extraneous solutions. For rational equations, extraneous solutions are values that cause any denominator in the original problem to be 0. Of course, when we have 0 in the denominator, we have an expression that is undefined. So we would have to throw out any values that would cause the denominator to be 0. Note that 7 does not cause any denominators to be 0, so it is not an extraneous solution. Also note that if we put 7 back in for a in the original problem, the two sides will be equal, which shows that 7 is the solution to our problem. So a equals 7 is our final answer.